Hi there, Lorenzo here from Omnis here. Today I'm going to show you how to start with Renovate Vehicle Framework. We're going to break down some of these components, learn about these various functionalities and how to customize them to your liking. Let's begin by explaining what it is. Renovate Vehicle Framework is a complete solution for creating high-quality vehicles inside a real engine, even if you don't have extensive programming knowledge. Its core is represented by a base vehicle blueprint class that encapsulates all its various functionalities, and child blueprint derived from it, which can be then designed to simulate various types of vehicles. It also includes interaction and driving animations, a circuit map with several environmental assets, few basic road spline meshes, and a series of blueprints aimed at creating drift and sprint races, which, however, are still under development and will be perfected in the next framework update. After you create your project and open it, you will find yourself in the showcase map, when you can test all the functionalities right away driving our template vehicle, the Riviera. You can use it as a perfect example for learning how to create your own vehicles, or if you wish, you can purchase some from our ever-growing car fleet on the UE marketplace. Link in the description. Renovate Vehicle Framework 1.0 is primarily designed to create four-wheeled vehicles, but it can also support a different number of wheels, as long as the physical behavior doesn't deviate significantly from the classic car concept. Therefore, motorcycles, tanks, and similar are excluded at the moment. Clicking on the Riviera, you'll notice how every child blueprint has a list of several parameters exposed, in order to let you set a few aspects on the fly through the detail panel. Along with camera settings, lights, turbo, and more, here you can change color easily with just a few clicks. This will allow you to differentiate the various instances in your map without too much effort. When you want to create a new vehicle though, you have to create a new child blueprint and edit its component inside the blueprint editor. Here you can change its skeletal mesh, reposition all its components like lights, interaction socket and so on, and set up the vehicle dynamics for the movement component. Let's see what we can design from here before we get to the other framework's functionalities. You can set the vehicle dynamics by opening the vehicle template you're working on, then click on the movement component in the component list and then up to the detail panel. First, we find wheel setup, in which you can decide how many wheels the vehicle will have, given that the rig matches the wheel amount, of course, and which wheel blueprint each of them should recall. We'll take a look at wheel blueprints in a moment, but what's important to get here is that in this section you can design which wheel turns, if they're affected by brakes or engine torque, just by referring to the right wheel blueprint. In steering setup, you can set the algorithm used to calculate the final turning ratio and the steering curve that drives the relation between speed and steering power. Moving to mechanical setup, we find engine setup, inside which are stored the torque curve that drives the relation between engine's RPM and torque, and the parameters that control how these two previous values are gonna work. So we have their max values, followed by four parameters that define how the RPM is gonna rise or fall smoothly accordingly to player's input. In differential setup, we can set the wheel drive, that should match what we set in the wheel setup above, plus a slider that describes the difference that occurs between front and rear wheel rotations. Transmission setup is where you set gears and their individual ratios, plus a basic parameter called final ratio. Their values should decrease in an even manner, but the more you get down, the less difference you'll need from the previous gear. Above, we have two switches that allow you to enable or disable automatic gear change. Please notice that manual gear change is not coded yet, while automatic reverse is turned off to not override our custom reverse function. Be aware, changes these two values will break stuff. Below, we have the up and down RPM values that trigger the automatic gear change, followed by the gear change time and the transmission efficiency, which determines how much power the vehicle will lose trying to move itself. Particularly helpful in making heavy vehicles like trucks and vans. Finally, vehicle setup lets you describe mass, width, and height of the chassis that are involved in vehicle physics, drag and downforce coefficient used to describe its aerodynamics, plus the slip threshold and slope limit that define when the movement component could be turned off to save performances. As we saw before, in wheel setup, every wheel is referring to a specific wheel blueprint that defines its characteristics. You can duplicate an existing one and alter its value to get many different configurations. In the first place, we can define the collision mesh plus a few options for its radius and width. Moving down, we find these 5 adherence parameters that will significantly change acceleration and drift feeling. Switches for enabling brakes, engine torque or modern traction safety mechanisms. Another switch for enabling steering and its max angle. And suspension parameters to define their length and dynamics, plus brake and handbrake torques. Another essential component that drives vehicle dynamics a lot is the physic asset. This file stores the vehicle's simple collisions and is used also to design the physical constraints that allow the simulation of moving parts. By selecting each body, you can find some information about their linear and rotational damping, max angular velocity, inertia tensor scale, and other helpful parameters used to favor the proper responses of vehicles to impacts. Simple collision also directly determines how the weight is gonna be spreaded across the chassis, or in other words, how the balance is gonna be. Okay, that was all about vehicle dynamics. All the other framework functionalities like interactions, UI, simulating moving parts and so on are coded in Blueprint and divided into 3 main scripts that you can explore inside RAM BP base vehicle. The construction script that handles the in-editor time changes you can make with the exposed parameter we saw at the beginning of this video. The event graph that handles runtime updates from UI text to sounds, camera follow, drift functionalities and more. And the vehicle input graph that handles player input, making movement and all the other gameplay actions possible. As you can see, all the functionalities are grouped in several subgraphs that you can open with a double click if you want to see the real code. Some of them have few parameters that can be exposed by promoting them to variables and clicking the eye icon next to them in the variable list. If you want, you can expose new ones while exploring the code to customize your base blueprint more and more. Let's talk about some of the core functionalities now. Another essential feature in racing games will be a simple camera management. Camera follow is a function that does just that by following the vehicle turning and detecting the moving direction in order to flip the view when going backwards. It can be found in the event graph inside the eventic subgraph. The player can pan the camera around as he wishes, and once he stops moving it, the camera will go back following the vehicle after a short delay, as long as the player is accelerating. Some exposed parameter then let you define if camera follow is enabled or not, its delay time and the turning ratio of both cameras. Inside the eventic subgraph as well, the drift graph tracks down skidding and slipping forces and multiply them by the vehicle velocity and drifting angle to assign drift points and fill a multiplier bar. The multiplier goes up to 4 per and gets increasingly difficult to fill, as well as faster to empty if you stop drifting. An impact will make you lose the accumulated drift points, as well as resetting the multiplier to 1 per. At the bottom part of the vehicle input graph, the IT graph takes in every IT event that exceeds the impact force screening threshold and categorizes them into light and heavy hits. Both will spawn their proper sound and a particle that follow the hit trajectory, but an heavy hit, other than taking some vehicle health, also undergoes a position check that automatically opens doorways if it's close enough. An open doorway activates then another function, this time placed in the event fix subgraph, that tracks its rotation and closes it when it gets slammed into lock position with enough force. You can disable auto-opening completely through the exposed parameters or set up the relock delay and threshold. The delay simply avoids that what's open doesn't close right the next frame, while easy threshold is used by the doors and normal threshold is for trunk and hood. Along with these exposed parameters, we also find IT damage divider, great for controlling how harmful impacts will be. Customizable colors are made possible through a proprietary material function called Value Mask, able to apply up to 44 color overlays on as many different areas of the mesh with a single RGBA texture. We don't actually need as many overlays layer though, so by default Renovate is using only 11 of them, storing this texture data in the alpha channel of every occlusion roughness metallic map. The colors are stored in pre-made material parameters collection called color palettes and get then applied whenever the set color palette function is called in different parts of the code. Creating a new color palette is relatively simple. Duplicate an existing color palette and drag the skeletal mesh of your vehicle into the map. Now open its paint material instance. If use color palette is enabled, you'll see a list of colors and alpha parameters that you can set in real time. The alpha values are gonna control how dirty the surface will look. Just make sure to compensate for the brightness change they will bring as well. Once you finish designing your custom colors, copy-paste them in the duplicated color palette. Use the shortcut Shift plus left or right mouse buttons to speed things up a bit. Now you have a new set of colors ready to be colored in real time. Drag and drop it into the color palette slot in the exposed parameters or set up an array of several color palettes, among which you can then switch at runtime. Nice! There were the basics you need to know to start developing with Renovate Vehicle Framework. Don't forget to join Renovate community on Discord and share your progress in the showcase channel. We are there just to help you. We'll see in the next video to learn how to add advanced locomotion system into our project. Until that moment, have fun creating our products. Cheers!